In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
It is Wednesday, the 9th of August, 2023, 18th week in ordinary time. And today we remember Saint Teresa Benedicta of the Cross, known as Edith Stein, who was born into a Jewish family in Poland in 1891. She lost her faith in her youth and became interested in philosophy. After reading the biography of Saint Teresa of Avila, she converted to the Catholic faith and was baptized in 1922. She taught in various places before joining the Carmel in Cologne, the Carmelites. At her religious profession, she took the name of Teresa Benedicta of the Cross. During the Nazi persecution of the Jews in World War II, she was arrested and taken to the concentration camp at Auschwitz. And that's where she died, in the gas chambers, on 9th August 1942. Our philosophical investigations have been very helpful to many of us who are in the field of philosophy, who lecture in universities and colleges, because this woman was a phenomenologist. This woman intermingled with Martin Heidegger and many other philosophers of her time. Participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Bosco Felix from South Sudan, celebrating his birthday today, texts for us the first reading. Anna Namusoke Serwada from Kampala, Uganda, celebrating her birthday today, texts for us the responsorio psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Marceline Irenge, a missionary of Africa studying in Rome, Italy. Let us pray. God of our fathers, who brought the martyr Saint Teresa Benedicta of the Cross to know your crucified Son and to imitate him, even until death, grant through her intercession that the whole human race may acknowledge Christ as its Savior and through him come to behold you for eternity, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. A reading from the book of Numbers. Numbers chapter 13, verse 1 to 2, and verse 25 to chapter 14, verse 1, 26 to 29, and verse 34 to 35. In those days, the Lord said to Moses, in the wilderness of Paran, send men to spy out the land of Canaan, which I give to the sons of Israel. From each tribe of their fathers shall you send a man, everyone a leader among them. At the end of 40 days, they returned from spying out the land. And they came to Moses and Aaron and to all the congregation of the sons of Israel in the wilderness of Paran at Kadesh. They brought back word to them and to all the congregation, and showed them the fruit of the land. And they told him, we came to the land to which you sent us. It flows with milk and honey, and this is its fruit. Yet the people who dwell in the land are strong, and the cities are fortified and very large. And besides, we saw the descendants of Anak there. The Amalekites dwell in the land of the Negeb. the Hittites, the Jebusites, and the Amorites dwell in the hill country, and the Canaanites dwell by the sea and along the Jordan. But Caleb quieted the people before Moses and said, Let us go up at once and occupy it, for we are well able to overcome it. Then the men who had gone up with him said, We are not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we. So they brought to the sons of Israel an evil report of the land which they had spied out, saying, The land through which we have gone to spy it out is a land that devours its inhabitants, and all the people that we saw in it are men of great stature. And there we saw the Nephilim, the sons of Anak, who come from the Nephilim. And we seemed to ourselves like grasshoppers, and so we seemed to them. Then all the congregation raised a loud cry, and the people wept that night. And the Lord said to Moses and to Aaron, How long shall this wicked congregation murmur against me? I have heard the murmurings of the sons of Israel, which they murmur against me. Say to them, As I live, says the Lord, what you have said in my hearing, I will do to you. Your dead bodies shall fall in this wilderness of all your number, numbered from 20 years old and upward, who have murmured against me, according to number of the days in which you spied out the land, 40 days, for every day a year you shall bear your iniquity 40 years, and you shall know my displeasure. I, the Lord, have spoken. Surely this will I do to all this wicked congregation that are gathered together against me. And this wilderness, they shall come to a full end, and there they shall die. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Psalm 106, chapter 6 to 7 AB, 13 to 14, 21 to 22, and 23. Response is taken from Psalm 106, verse 4a. And the response is, O Lord, remember us with the favor you showed to your people.
O Lord, remember us with the favor you showed to your people.
Like our fathers, we have sinned. We have done wrong. Our deeds have been evil. Our forebears, when they were in Egypt, did not grasp the meaning of your wonders.
O Lord, remember us with the favor you showed to your people.
But they soon forgot his deeds and would not wait upon his counsel. They yielded to their cravings in the desert and put God to the test in the wilderness.
O Lord, remember us with the favor you showed to your people.
They forgot the God who was their Savior, who had done such great things in Egypt, such wonders in the land of Ham, such marvels at the Red Sea.
O Lord, remember us with the favor you showed to your people.
For this he said he would destroy them, but Moses, the man he had chosen, stood in the breach before him to turn back his anger from destruction.
O Lord, remember us with the favor you showed to your people.
Gospel Acclamation, Luke chapter 7, verse 16. Alleluia, a great prophet has arisen among us, and God has visited his people. Alleluia.
O woman, great is your faith. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 15, verse 21 to 28. At that time Jesus went away and withdrew to the district of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a Canaanite woman from that region came out and cried, Have mercy on me, O Lord, son of David. My daughter is severely possessed by a demon. But he did not answer her a word. And his disciples came and begged him, saying, Send her away, for she is crying after us. He answered, I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. But she came and knelt before him, saying, Lord, help me. And he answered, It is not fair to take the children's bread and throw it to the dogs. She said, Yes, Lord, yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table. Then Jesus answered her, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you desire." And her daughter was healed instantly. The good news of our salvation.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have an interesting incident here of the spies who were sent to go and see the promised land. And they went there and came back feeling discouraged that nothing was going to work out because they found giants there. That's not a place for us. We can't fight those giants. We can't overcome them. We are doomed. And they even exaggerated it as they told the people how difficult it is to go to the promised land. And you know, people cried the whole night. We are doomed. We are dead. We are finished. But here is my interpretation. Look at this. The promised land for us believers is heaven. And all of us are spies for heaven. We are spies for heaven in the sense we are supposed to show to others how heaven is like. It is a land of giants. It is a land of fit people. It is a land of people who are bold. That is heaven. That is Canaan. And they fear that they cannot make it. We have so many people who fear, who think that they cannot make it to heaven because they think indeed heaven is only for perfect people. No, it is for anyone who is bored to do things right. That is heaven. And so don't scare people to think that they cannot be sent. Don't scare people to think that they cannot reach that level. No, all of us are giants. Every human being has the ability to reach the land of giants. Don't make things look like it's extremely difficult for people to access heaven. Oh, you think you make it to heaven? No, 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 no. That's not a place for people like you. No, there is a place for people like you. There is a place for you as you show your kindness to your fellow human being. You are that giant who deserves to be in Canaan. There is a place for you as you show your compassion, your love, your forgiveness to others. You are that giant who can stay in the promised land. There is a place for you when you are accommodating enough, when you are able to embrace people from all walks of life, from all religious affiliations, when you are able to eat with somebody who doesn't belong to your religion, there is a place for you in that Canaan. There is a place for you in that land of promise. So you can see that the people of Israel, while in that desert, were not able to be in good terms with the people of Canaan. And this explains to you why the gospel passage of today talks of the Canaanite woman. That Canaanite woman coming from the Canaanites, who are not in good terms with the Jews, could not benefit from things that were meant for the Jews. And so Jesus keeps quiet. When she's requesting for help, Jesus keeps quiet here. And as he keeps quiet, the Canaanite woman kept insisting until she got what she wanted. Jesus said he was only sent to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. But she came and knelt before him, "Lord, help me. No, it's not fair to give the children's bread and throw it to the dogs." She did not give up. You know, sometimes we pray and answers don't come. We receive silence. And many of us decide to give up because there is silence on the other side. We pray twice. We pray three times. We give up because we don't seem to receive any answer. If you want to belong to Canaan, The Canaanite woman is showing you the way. Don't give up on prayer. There is a place for you in the land of the giants. This woman came from the land of the giants, and she was able to persist. No, you will have to give me what I'm looking for. No, I cannot give you. I came only for the lost children of Israel. Wait a minute. So, you are that selfish? So, you are a racist? So, you discriminate? No, that's not the case. Jesus was testing this Canaanite woman, was testing the giant in this Canaanite woman. And indeed, she was a giant. She did not give up. She lowered herself to even wanting to eat the scraps from the table of the master as a dog. I'm telling you, if you are a giant, you will not care about the insults of other people. If you feel you are a giant inside you, whatever people are going to say against you will not stop you from getting what you are looking for. And this woman is coming from the land of the giants, and she insisted until Jesus opened the doors, even to the outsiders, to the foreigners. With that, Christianity became a religion that is universal, that is accessible to anyone, even somebody who is not a Jew, even somebody who is not within the territory of the redeemed. We all have access to the land of promise. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Wednesday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my favorite. You're there. Spoken to me, and I'm desperate for you. And your bed.